Dave Ebert. I'm the program manager for the Pacific Shark Research Center at Moss Landing Marine Laboratories, which is part of the San Jose State University. Well, right now we're in Grahamstown, South Africa at the South African Institute for Aquatic Biodiversity. And we're here to do capacity building with researchers from South Africa, Tanzania, Mozambique, and we're investigating the guitarfishes. People like in Western countries are not familiar with because they don't occur there, but these are perhaps the most endangered group of fishes in the world. And many of them are listed as endangered or critically endangered by the IUCN Red List. And so I've been here working in Africa for 35 years, and we're still finding new things, including these new guitarfish that we found that recently came up from off Tanzania and Mozambique.
Our region is very rich. We've got a rich biodiversity. But then because we do not have experts, identification is lagging behind. So even though we know that we've got sharks, at the moment we don't know how many sharks we have in our region. So having an expert like Dave coming to SAIAB and training taxonomists, upcoming taxonomists within the region, I think is going to contribute more to identification of new fish species within our region.
By empowering the local scientists in terms of conservation, what's important is that it's their country, it's their community. I'm just an outsider there, but I just want to give them tools that they can use. And so by discovering and naming these species and getting them described, they can take that information, use it in a, you know, conservation or for fisheries management to their fisheries agencies, and then here's what we need to do.
These are our resources. We need to be involved. We need to identify them. Now that he's sharing the knowledge to us, it is our responsibility to take over and be the leading taxonomist within the region. If we do not know what we have, if we do not know their name, we cannot conserve them because we cannot conserve what we don't know.
Now, when people tend to think of sharks, they tend to think like jaws, like something big and toothy, like a great white shark or a tiger shark, something charismatic. Most people don't realize that there's 1,300 species of sharks in the world, and yet the vast majority of them, people have no idea that they even exist, and those are really what I call the lost sharks. What's fascinating about them and what's really important about them is that they will actually tell you more about the health of the marine environment than something like a white shark will, because a lot of these species may be vanishing right before our eyes with no one really knowing about it or realizing it because they don't pay any attention to them. And so my sort of mission throughout my career has been to go out and to try to find these species and to identify them and in some cases describe new species, which is really important because these really are the proverbial canaries in the coal mine. They'll tell you more about the health of the marine environment because by the time you see an impact like at a white shark or a tiger shark level, it's probably gonna be almost too late because all those species below that have been wiped out, whether it's from fishing, development, climate change, whatever, but those are being impacted. And those are the ones you really need to focus on now before it's too late.
I've often thought if I was going to have my career again, I'd become a taxonomist. And one of the most exciting findings really is that we're discovering a new shark or ray species every single week or every second week. And these aren't small deep water sharks. 10 years ago, we had one species of manta ray. Now we have two and possibly even three. And so I actually find taxonomy of sharks and rays fascinating because every new week brings us a new insight into the diversity of these iconic predators.
When people ask me, like, was there still more to be discovered, I'm saying, I'm sure there is, because in the last 20 years, of the 1,300 species of sharks we know today, 25% of them were discovered within the last 20 years. So who knows how many more will be discovered over the next 20 years. I'm looking forward to the Ocean Census program because I think it could be very important because they're focused on enabling people to describe new species and they provide support for expeditions and to run workshops like this. So I think it's an invaluable tool because there's not really many organizations that provide that opportunity, and the Ocean Census is one.